Bonjour! We are here with this wonderful new French film, which I really, really loved. It's called, en français, Adieu ma reine, but in English it's Farewell, My Queen. And it's about Marie Antoinette's last days, and we're here with the French-speaking director, of course, bien sûr, Benoît Jacquot, monsieur.
Bonjour, bonjour, bonjour.
Je vous parle en français,
mais s'il vous plaît. S'il vous plaît, s'il vous plaît.
Oui, peut-être je comprends.
Film français, metteur en scène français, parler reine de France.
Oui. Et, elle est une... Marie Antoinette was a lesbian?
Peut-être.
Peut-être.
Et pourquoi pas?
And why not?
Voilà. Peut-être.
Because in those days, everything was so...
Non, mais elle, she was alone, you know, in that big place Versailles, and her husband, the king, was always hunting, not
paying attention to her.
No,
yeah.
So she had friends, girlfriends, and maybe she had some love affairs with them. That's what it was said, but
it was said at the time.
Yeah.
Now she was.
Maybe it was true.
She's become this, you know, to Americans, she's become over, you know, the centuries, this symbol that just hasn't changed of the poor French queen who got her head cut off in the revolution. There was this terrible thing. And, of course, the people in France at the time,
they hated her.
Why did they hate her?
Because she was, you know, French people are very, very... comment on dit ça, chauvin, national, hexagonal, chauvinistic.
National.
Oh, yes, terrible. When they see
German.
a foreigner becoming a queen, for the French people, it's a kind of horror.
And she was German, Austrian?
Austrian.
Austrian, mm. Okay.
Yeah.
And they didn't like that, and also they didn't like the fact that she...
She was a fashion. She invented the fashion in a way, so she transformed that huge castle, the Versailles Palace, which was the biggest palace in the world at this time. She transformed it in a kind of cabaret, and that was very nice. But the people were not eating, they were very poor, so it seemed to them that it was something monstrous.
Yes, the famous phrase, laissez-les manger du gâteau, is that, did she really say that, let them eat cake?
But as far as I know, it's not true. She never said that. But people said that she was saying that.
But the disparity between the poor and the rich was... gigantic at the time. Oui?
Enormous, yes.
Enormous.
Yes.
Enorme.
Enorme.
Enorme. I know a few words of French.
They couldn't eat anything. It was very, very... That's the reason of the revolution.
And I have to say, I know you're one of France's great directors for American audience who don't know, and our French audience, of course, knows your great work, Benoit. These beautiful actresses, wonderful performances. Wonderful.
Ouais. Très belle.
Superb.
Très belle actrice. Oui, très important.
Oui. And it's good actresses.
You know, it's a very famous German, but American director, Ernst Lubitsch. You know Lubitsch?
Oui,
he said, the cinema is the art to make beautiful women doing very nice things.
Enfin,
le cinéma, hein? C'est l'art de faire de jolies choses à de jolies femmes.
I love it in French. Say that again. I love that phrase.
Oui, c'est ça.
Le cinéma, c'est faire. C'est l'art de faire de jolies choses à de jolies femmes.
Well, I think that certainly in the other ages, you know, of cinema in the last century, the women did dominate films, especially American films, and it's so refreshing to see wonderful actresses giving great, large performances of great range and depth and epic.
Yes, I like it too. And for me, it's very important to
and
do that.
And we're going to be talking to Diane Kruger in a few minutes, who is German.
Ah, she's German, but she works mostly in States and in France.
Because
Because her accent seemed to me parfait. You know, her
son accent français. Oui. Elle a un petit accent très joli, comme Marie Antoinette, comme la reine Marie Antoinette. Pareil.
Je connais tous. Et also, eh bien, votre caméra est extraordinaire. La cinématographie, was it steady cam? I mean, chasing people through hallways.
No, it's camera on the shoulder.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but
wow.
It's a very good, very, very good cinematographer.
Because there was this urge. I mean, this is the French Revolution, like we've never seen it. It was like backstage and underground, you know, how their servants were all reacting. What were the people reacting in the rooms of Versailles? The Tizans, how I saw.
Oui,
very powerful.
L'idée, c'est de reconstituer les choses comme si elles surgissaient, comme si elles se passaient à l'instant même.
It, the idea was really to show things, to recreate them in such a way that you felt them as though they were happening at that moment, at that time.
Which I did, exactement.
Alors si c'est, donc c'est bon, c'est réussi alors.
Because you're in these underground. Was that filmed at Versailles? Was that
tourné what?
C'était tourné à Versailles.
Oui.
So then we were underground, following in these corridors on and on.
Dans le dos de cette fille qui travaille à Versailles.
On, really seeing it on the back of this woman, this young woman who lived there and who worked there. This is her world.
Right, and she and you see the confusion, the chaos, the catastrophe.
Panic.
Oui, because they don't know what's going on. I mean,
c'est comme un naufrage. Comme un naufrage.
Oui, oui, exactement.
Voilà.
And you see it hitting them in waves, as you say, shipwreck. All of the news, and they're like, what? What?
Ouais,
they can't believe it.
Ouais. Panique totale et accélération de toutes les réactions.
Oui, je comprends ça. Mon français. But it's fantastic. Fantastic, because you're like, with them, and you don't, you know, it's so far away, and then you think, but the guillotine, this, that, the guillotine, and this, all this, that, and then you realize that's how these people must have really experienced it.
On peut, en tout cas, c'est le, moi, c'est l'idée que j'ai de ça, et j'ai essayé de la rendre vraisemblable.
That was the idea that I had of it, and it was my intention to really try to make this seem realistic.
And you did. You did.
Merci.
Fantastic. Merci. Fantastic. I hope that this film gets considered for Oscars, etc. this year. I was able to help Jean Dujardin and Marion Cotillard, so peut-être. I know. It's getting France to say this is their entry to the Oscars. I think if that happens, you'll win Best Foreign Film. You've got to get France to say this is the one.
Si le film est nominé par la France comme leur candidat pour le meilleur film étranger.
Je ne sais pas. Peut-être c'est la France qui doit dire que c'est ce film-là qui représente pour les Oscars. Bon,
it's
on verra.
It's France that has to say that this is the film that it wants to have representing France for the Oscars.
France, do that, okay? I'm telling you. And the costumes.
Beautiful.
That can get nominated. That's for sure. I mean, the costume. Who did the costumes?
C'est un costumiste très, très connu en France qui s'appelle Christian Gasque.
Christian Gasque. Ouais. Magnifique. They can just nominate him without the French approval of the... Do you know what I'm saying?
On peut nominer pour les costumes sans avoir un officiel.
Non, mais écoute, les Oscars, on s'en fout.
The Oscars are crazy.
Yes,
non,
I know.
On s'en fout.
Oh, we don't care about them.
Right. Well, I'm the Oscar messenger.
Voilà,
so that's
voilà.
Donne
ton Oscar. Il a qu'à donner son Oscar, lui, son Oscar virtuel, et tout va bien.
Mm-hmm.
Et je suis très content.
Your virtual Oscar, and I'll be very happy.
Well, I'm just, I don't know, I am the Oscar messenger, that's what they call me. So they always have me here to talk to about the Oscars, to get the idea going, you know.
D'accord.
To commence the buzz.
Le buzz, très bien, d'accord. Parfait, d'accord.
And it's such a good film, with such great performances by actresses. I'm you could all be going to the Oscars in February. Je pense. I hope. J'espère.
Très bien.
Très bien. Et merci. Merci. And votre nom, mademoiselle?
Ellen Sauchak.
Okay, Ellen. Thank you. Au revoir.
Merci.